On Sunday, a piece of Nanda Devi Glacier burst open into Dholi Ganga River near Reni village in Uttarakhand, which triggered an avalanche and the floodwaters burst open a dam and swept away a number of houses. Lives were lost and many are reported missing. But what led to such a devastating disaster? Could we have seen it coming? Welcome back to Thought Control, and today we are going to discuss about glacier burst in Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand, more precisely the Chamoli region in particular, is generally regarded to be a geologically unstable region. An increasing population has only made things worse. In July 2004, a hydrometeorological disaster caused a landslide killing 16 people in Joshimath, the epicenter of the current disaster. In June 2005, another hydrometeorological disaster in Chamoli brought a huge quantity of debris and rock boulders down a seasonal stream. 11 people were killed. In 2013, hundreds of people died in Uttarakhand flood that devastated Chamoli, Bageshwar, Pithorgarh, Rudraprayag, and Uttarkashi. Cloudburst induced flash floods and landslide back then, ravaging Kedarnath town. Sunday's tragedy fell near Reni village, some 25 km from Joshimath in Garhwal. Around half a dozen bridges were damaged due to the flood water. Experts are calling it a very rare incident, as it was a fairly large chunk of the glacier that broke off. Scientists aren't even entirely sure what caused the flooding. A glacial lake burst, a cloud burst, an avalanche, the impact of climate change or development. But the scenario being most talked about was the glaciologists like to call a GLOF, or glacial lake outburst flood. Climate change has caused worldwide global warming and is resulting in melting of glacier all over the planet. And melting glacier usually result in the formation of lake at their tips. So, glacial lakes are essentially water bodies that form beneath big glaciers. When the boundaries of these lakes break, they create enough pressure to break off huge chunks of glacier, leading to large amount of water flooding down to nearby streams and rivers, gathering speed on the way by picking up sediments, rocks, and other material. Events like these are not unusual, but their impact depends on the size of chunk that is broken off. Now the thing is, these breaches can be caused by several different regions. For example, an avalanche. The possibility of a GLOF is being cautioned mainly because of scientists do not know of any big glacial lakes in this region. While avalanches in this region are quite common, but then an avalanche on its own would not result in an increase in the flow of water in the river. The water has to come from a source, and as of now, researchers are not sure of the source of the water. It is also possible that a glacial lake was present in the area but was not known of. If huge chunks of snow because of an avalanche would fall on such an area, it could also result in breaking the boundaries of these lakes. Still, satellite images could not find any glacial lakes in that area, but there have been instances where lakes form deep inside the glacier, undetectable to the satellites. The theory of cloudburst causing this event has very low probability, as they are not expected this time of the year. Are there any other explanation? Well, some researchers feel that it is perfectly possible that a landslide or an avalanche created an obstruction on the path of the river, essentially creating a makeshift dam. When the pressure of the flowing water started increasing, the natural dam would have probably broken away. But if it was indeed caused by glacier burst, the link of tragedy to climate change and global warming cannot be denied. And the entire Himalayan Hindu Kush stretch of mountains is considered a hotspot of climate change. A 2019 study spanning 40 years of satellite observation across India, China, Nepal, and Bhutan had warned that a Kedarnath-like tragedy may happen again in the Himalayan region. The study found that formation of glacial lakes in the Himalayan region had increased by 50% since 2000. The NASA study found that glaciers were losing ice equivalent to 1.5 feet of vertical measure since 2000. That's twice the pace of melting observed between 1975 and 2000. Another study published in Nature last year said glacier retreat had risen by 50% since 1990. Formation of large number of these glacial lakes pose an existential threat. The increasing number of glacial lakes make the entire Uttarakhand region susceptible to present glacier burst like disaster. Reduction of risk has to begin with identifying and mapping such lakes, taking structural measures to prevent their sudden breach, and stabilizing mechanism to save lives and property in times of breach. A study found that there are 352, 283, and 1393 glacial lakes and water bodies in the Indus, Ganga, and Brahmaputra basins respectively. The use of synthetic aperture radar imagery to automatically detect changes in water bodies, including new lake formation, is recommended. While the work on identification is being done, the other aspects like a robust warning system or rescue teams stationed at high-risk places are still not even halfway there. But you know, as they say, precaution is better than cure. Nature is not a toy we can play with without expecting consequences. Just 200 years of industrialization and this is where we are, waiting for global catastrophe to strike at any hour. The only real solution is to change our ways to give way to sustainable development, a world where nature and man can live together. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked our content, then please do subscribe the channel and do not forget to press on bell icon.